Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Aren't you glad to be in the house of the Lord tonight? Praise God. Aren't you glad to be in the house of the Lord tonight?
Amen.
Thank you for the blood. Always good to be here with our great man, folks, Flurry. And just to give you a little bit of a praise report, this morning I was unctioned by the Holy Ghost to preach about the widow that Elijah was sent to in the country of Sidon. And I got to wrestling with, why would God send him to a widow woman that had her last meal ready to prepare it and to feed her son, and she resigned her fact to the fact that she was going to die after she ate her last supper, you might say. And the man of God showed up, and the first thing he did was ask for water, the thing that he prophesied and said there won't be any rain. Right. For 3.5 years, he had the audacity to ask her for a cup of water. And I am quickened to think that when she fixed him a little cake, that she was literally scraping the bottom
right.
of the barrel.
That's right. That's right.
That expression comes from the bottom of the barrel does a last resort or the very worst of what I have left. And it was like the Lord spoke to me. What do you do when you get to the bottom of the barrel? What is in the bottom of the barrel? The miracle of God
right.
is in the bottom of the barrel.
Amen.
When you get down to nothing, God's up to something.
Right.
Oh, come on.
Right. That's right. That's right.
After that message, Pastor Flurry, I went and prayed for a young lady that was married to Quincy Rice. If she didn't receive the Holy Ghost, she literally stood there and shook under the power of God this morning. Oh, I'm so thankful for the power of God. When you're down to nothing, God's still a miracle
right.
in the bottom of the barrel. Isn't that right?
Amen.
God bless you. God bless you. God bless you tonight. It is so good to be here. I apologize for being late. And but better late than never, I guess. But I didn't want to miss this tonight. And this young man that we're bringing to you tonight has been faithful. He's been faithful. He's been faithful his whole life to Apostolic Tabernacle. And today I officially announced him as my assistant pastor. And I want you to know those folks were really excited about Brother Danny and Sister Amanda being our new assistant pastor. And he's a great young man, got a great heart tonight. And I'm so thankful that Pastor Flurry gave him an opportunity. I know Brother Flurry is in mourning today because of his spouse. And I know that he knows he needs a lift up, you know, after what the Falcons done to him. And so I knew he would be in bad shape. And we're so thankful that we can lend him, Brother Edwards, here tonight. Let's give the Lord a good praise tonight.
Amen.
Come on, Brother Dean Edwards and the Lord. God bless you, sir.
That's funny.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Let me see you for a moment. He said the whole church was excited. I went over to Pastor Flurry and told him, I said, someone had to be, I'm scared. I've always heard that if you aren't afraid of it, it's probably not the will of God. So,
all right.
I want to thank Pastor Flurry for this opportunity. I don't take it lightly. Any pulpit you stand behind is an opportunity to reach people
that's right.
that need God. And you cannot take that opportunity lightly.
All right.
This is something that I was, like he said about bishops, I was raised under a bishop that believed in truth and believed in holy and believed you step behind a pulpit, that's all you deliver.
All right.
So I hope to stand up strong in what he taught me.
Yes, sir.
So I'm going to be in Deuteronomy chapter 1. We can all stand. We started in verse 40. Very familiar story, something that I was actually been working on for a long time, and this is the day.
All right.
It says in verse 40, but as for you, turn you and take your journey into the wilderness by the way of the Red Sea. Then he answered and said unto me, We have sinned against the Lord, we will go up and fight according to all that the Lord our God commanded us. And when he had girded on every man his weapons of war, he were ready to go up into the hill. And the Lord said unto me, Say unto them, Go not up, neither fight, for I am not among you, lest ye be smitten before your enemies. So I spake unto you, and ye would not hear, but rebelled against the commandment of the Lord, and went presumptuously up into the hill. And the Amorites, which dwelt in that mountain, came out against you and chased you, as bees do, and destroyed you in Seir, even unto the bottom. And ye returned and wept before the Lord, but the Lord would not hearken to your voice, nor give ear unto you. Verse 46 says, So ye abode in Kadesh many days, according to the days that ye abode there. I want to speak for just a little while on this thought. No comfort in uncertainty.
Right.
No comfort in uncertainty. We pray. Lord, I love you today, God. I thank you for the opportunity you've given us to come together and to hear your word and follow your mercy and grace. Ask you, Lord, to touch our hearts and minds, God, as you deliver here in the Lord. Ask you, Lord, that you can that they hear the way that you gave it into my heart. God, thanks for all in Jesus' name.
Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. You may be seated. The beginning of my reading, it says that they took their journey in the wilderness by the way of the Red Sea. They cut through the Red Sea, went into the wilderness. They were given a promised land. And, you know, they kind of, you know, sent the spies up and they did the whole process, but they missed what God was trying to do.
All right.
They missed the opportunity that God had given them, and they instead walked back out into a wilderness land that was called Kadesh. And I started studying out what this land meant. And as I studied this out, the land they were told to go into this wilderness, they were stuck in a land that was called Kadesh, and it was filled with uncertainty.
Uh-huh.
Let me explain it a little bit. This land was known by its false gods.
Right.
This land was known by their prostitution out of the temples. Their priests were known to be this form. That everything about this place, this land, was uncertain. There was uncertainty in yourself, uncertainty in the people around you, uncertainty in the gods that they served. Everything about Kadesh screamed uncertainty. There was nothing sure, nothing strong, and nothing truthful about this land called Kadesh. Kadesh was not a place of comfort. It wasn't a place where they went through and everything seemed to be okay. Everything about Kadesh was uncertain. And I don't know about you, but I know me, when I'm in a land that is uncertain, I'm not comfortable. If I'm in a place I don't know, I'm uncomfortable. And then when they start spreading false truth about God, I get more uncomfortable. Because at this point in time, they're taking away from the truth of Jesus in baptism and the filling of the Holy Ghost. And they're taking and they're feeding, and they're trying to make people believe the lies of the devil. This land is not a land where you go through and you just decide that everything's going to be okay here. This is the land that you spend your entire life here. This land lost Israel a generation.
All right.
Instead of heading straight to the land of the promise like they were told, they sent these spies and brought this mixed report.
Yeah.
And this mixed report had good and bad, more bad than good.
Right.
But instead of believing that God who brought them out of Egypt, and brought them out of all of the things they've been fighting for 400 years. All of these things, instead of believing in it and following after God, they decided, you know what? Maybe the bad report is something I should listen to. Doesn't make sense to me.
Yeah.
But they went into the wilderness.
Yeah.
They stepped into this land of uncertainty and uncomfort. And they thought that this would be better than what God had given them.
All right.
We live in a day today that is filled with uncertainty.
All right.
Everywhere we go, it is uncertain. Right. Every place we step, there is no comfort. Right. Everywhere we go as a Christian, we should feel a little bit of resistance against what we're going through.
Right.
Because in the schools, they're not teaching God. They're not
Come on.
God in.
Come on.
Everything we do in this day and age, there is a fight against Christianity.
Right.
And I'm here to tell you today, we're walking and we're living in a modern day Kadesh. We're living in uncertainty.
Right.
And I'm here to tell you today, if we stand up just one time for the things of God, we will get the promise just
right.
One time of the things that God has given us. If we can believe boldly the things that God has given us as a people, this church has a city full of people who are uncertain of of God's lightning into the
praise
world.
Praise God.
He is. We are still not sure. We're living in a world of people who are not sure because they've been listening to the ugly heartedness of men.
All right.
Yeah, we live in a world that too many people have something to say about God, and it's not the truth. We live in a world that too many people are comfortable in teaching false precepts and false lightningness of God.
Come on.
I don't know about you, but I still believe there's only one God.
That's right.
I still believe that the Holy Ghost is real.
Right.
I still believe that Jesus said baptism is the only route to heaven. I believe that with my whole heart.
Right. Amen.
Am I saying that your will and your journey isn't going to happen, that the hard times aren't going to come? No, they will. But you don't have to choose them. You think that sometimes hard times will show up, but you don't have to make the choice to walk through it.
Right.
You can make the choice to take the promise.
Praise God.
I believe wholeheartedly that just like Jackson battled three paths, some problems.
Sure.
I believe wholeheartedly, just like Jackson, this church has a promise.
Sure. Yeah.
And I believe it so much so that I'm here to make a declaration.
Alright.
That this church was given a promise. That this church was given a city. And this church was given a time and a place for it to happen. And
right. Praise God.
A place of comfort and certainty. When people want to know what the truth of God is, they step through these doors. When they want to know who God is and how powerful He is, they're going to step through these doors. This is the place. This is the time. This is comfort. This is certainty.